talked about Bruce Bowen and that people feel that
he wears on you, man. Yeah. He just irritates you. And when it comes time to this time of game, you just get sick of it, especially when you're having a bad game and things are going this
Bruce's story is, I think it's one of the great stories, you know, in the NBA.
Left corner, Bowen fires a three from there. It's good.
And when you're willing to do what others can't or won't do, and Bruce Bowen, whose level of credibility and integrity and the standard of excellence in his life, and you see what he has done as a human being. Forget about the basketball success, but what he's done as a person, it is just fantastically inspirational to the point of, yeah, I'm with that guy.
Bruce Bowen leading the attack for the San Antonio Ball Club.
That's where he makes his mark. He studies guys, and what's great about Bruce, he has great hands and he's in incredible shape.
You're in grade school and you're going through the cafeteria line and you got your tray and you're going through and get to the end of the line and you turn and there's that kid at the end that just swats the tray out of your hands. That's Bruce Bowen.
Now we gotta ask.
Cal State Fullerton basketball coach Donnie Daniels answers a call in 1992 from a high school coach in Fresno. He's touting an overlooked 6'6 forward who will be playing in a tournament nearby that weekend. Daniels bites. The uncommitted prospect drops 38 and is named the tournament's MVP. He signs him. Good story. Only problem is that it wasn't true. There was a tournament and prospect that was signed, only it wasn't the high school coach who called. It was the MVP.
My pitch was simple. Now, mind you, we don't have caller ID. So I pick up going, hello, my name is Bill Engel. I'm from Edison High School here in Fresno, California.
Bowen had a good career at Fullerton, eventually earning an All-Big West first-team selection his senior year. Still, he went undrafted in 1993 and uninvited to any NBA camps. One scouting report painted an unflattering picture, describing him as, quote, a below-average athlete and an all-around talent. A good enough spot-up shooter to not be a complete offensive liability. Undeterred, Bowen took his game to France. Often sitting in the stands was a young point guard prospect in his family who befriended the American.
Comment ça va? Tu vas bien?
Oui.
Je m'appelle Bruce Bowen. Je suis basketteur à la FBO. ALM. A gagné. Oui.
For me personally, he was like my big brother. Growing up in France, I used to go watch him when he was playing in France. And my dad used to give him some advice and try to make him a better player. And so when I got drafted by the Spurs, it was like almost like a dream to play with him because growing up, I was watching him all the time.
Bruce spent the next 4 years bouncing between three different French clubs, averaging nearly 28 points a game. He also spent some of the time playing in the Continental Basketball Association, where he caught the attention of the Miami Heat. He signed a 10-day contract that garnered just that 10 days. Bowen persisted. The Celtics called the next season with a real contract. After one more stop with Philly, Bowen ended up back in Miami, this time with guarantees. But unlike his high-scoring days overseas, it was his defense that was becoming his calling card.
And Bowen with another steal.
Four solid defense by Bowen.
Took it right away from Pierce. Here he comes, a bucket and the foul.
And it's what put the soon-to-be free agent on the Spurs' radar in 2001.
Bruce was an offensive player in France. And like, how the hell did that happen?
Bowen!
But Tony, growing up and coming to the team right in that same time, his impressions of Bruce were like a guy that could go out and score 20 points a game. That wasn't going to happen with Pop as a coach. Foundationally, Pop, in his heart, wants to be a great defensive team. We recruited Bruce at the time that Kobe Bryant was kicking our ass.
He carried himself with a swag that just exuded confidence.
For three, yes! Bryant guarded by Ginobili out front. Kobe pulls up, fakes the jumper, now takes one over Manu, and that one is good for Kobe Bryant.
Bryant!
I know that part of the reason why that Bruce Bowen is part of San Antonio Spurs is for Kobe.
10% with 16 offensive rebounds.
Here's the play. Once again, got the reverse.
Two play, this time Grant.
That was the target matchup as we walked into Bruce, was how do we guard Kobe?
While back in Fresno for a visit, there was another important call. But this time, Bruce was Bruce.
Going through a driveway of a Rowley's Burgers one day. Phone rings, hello? Hey, Bruce, this is Greg Popovich. Yeah, right, Charlie. Click. You know, after I hung up, I'm like, I don't know if my buddy Charlie really knew anything about that. Phone rings again. Hey, Bruce, this is Greg Popovich. And I'm like, Pop, hey, how are you doing, sir?
After meeting Bowen, the Spurs knew they had their man, and they didn't want to take any chances of losing him.
Bruce was in China on an NBA-sponsored event. And so we came to an agreement with Bruce, and we sent Lance Blanks to China to sign the contract because we were concerned that if he came back to the U.S. without it being signed already, that Miami and the teams that Bruce had already been a part of were going to be waiting there at the airport trying to kidnap him. So Lance Blanks went halfway around the world to make sure we got the early signature on the contract.
Bryant for three. Yes!
Bryant guarded by Ginobili out front. Kobe pulls up, fakes the jumper, now takes one over Manu, and that one is good for Kobe Bryant. Bryant in the front court. Bowen is out on Kobe Bryant.
Bryant dances and shoots the three ball. Good. Bryant putting the move on Bowen. Blocked by Bowen. How about Bruce Bowen?
I can't say enough about Bruce Bowen, the way he's played in this series.
Hey. And here's Bryant, stopped by Bowen.
While Bowen's amazing ascension finally produced his dream job, there was still plenty of hard work left to do. That suited the new Spur just fine.
Brett Brown and Bruce came into this gym and spent thousands of hours working together.
When most of the league was, you know, taking a break and maybe getting away from basketball, letting their bodies recover, mentally, you know, kind of recharge, Bruce just, he worked year round.
Bruce even made himself a good corner three-point shooter.
Bowen wants the three. And got it when he needed it most.
We knew that he was defense oriented. He had a high motor on that end, but it took a little bit. I think understanding who you have in certain positions takes some experience, takes some time. Bruce has got so and so today. All right, cool. He's taken care of. He's got him. We got to make sure that we do our job on this end.
One of the best player development staffs in the league and an all-NBA lineup around him brought Bruce's game up to a new level.
The premier perimeter defender in the NBA there, avoiding the foul by pulling his hands back.
Keeping Tracy McGrady in front of him. Forcing contact but staying in front. The defense, and this is how you do it. Extend, active hands, gives the cushion, ready to contest.
What an assignment he's had in the playoffs. All right, guard Allen Iverson. That was in the first round against Denver. You also have to guard Carmelo Anthony as well. All right, so you move past the second round. Now you have to take on Steve Nash. Then Deron Williams, who was one of the hotter players in the playoffs. And now you get to guard LeBron James. It's why he's considered by many as the best perimeter defender in the league.
But there was still some of that scrappy kid from West Fresno, too.
If you react to something I do, that's when that piqued my curiosity. So it's kind of like you see cartoon characters and one cartoon individual keeps poking, and the other, stop it. Well, that poke for me was, oh, there's something here. Let me delve into this a little bit more. I'm gonna come back, you know, but I'm just gonna set up shop right here. And the worst thing you could do with me is to let me know that you don't like something. That, don't let anybody else know. Don't let me know. Because if I know, it's going to be trouble.
Night in and night out, the league's best got to tune in to see that cartoon character.
He gets a technical and he might be heading for number two. There it is, he's gone.
Not everyone was amused.
Two Bruce Bowen stories that I'll never forget and didn't realize it, never knew, ever heard of Bruce Bowen until I jumped into the San Antonio Mavericks-Dallas Mavericks rivalry. The defensive tactics that he employed out there on the floor were crazy. And I had a front row seat because he was my matchup. He was the guy designed to stop me and frustrate me. And he did it. Like, he succeeded. I'm gonna give him that. Out of all the guys that have ever guarded me in my career, Bruce Bowen was one of the toughest because he had tactics. One time, no lie, I go up for a shot and he cocks back and he swings like he's gonna take my head off. I go up for the shot and I duck and I turn the ball over, and Coach Avery Johnson would never let me live that moment down on film. He was like, what are you doing, son? You thought he was gonna hit you? Man, get out of here, man. Hats off to Bruce. He's one of the greatest defenders to ever lace him up.
For all the adversaries Bowen might have made on the court, he more than made up for it off of it. A quick survey in San Antonio about what fans remember most about Bruce would likely place him outside the arena.
Well, Bruce Bowen has always been a guy who would, you know, say yes to a lot of the requests we would make of him because of his passion for San Antonio and this community.
He's always very involved, and he was always available and doing a lot of things for kids, and always with a good example.
The Spurs' success during Bowen's 8 seasons was unmatched. The team claimed 4 division titles and 3 championships. Individually, Bruce was named to the NBA All-Defensive First Team 5 times. But time waits for no one. When Bowen found out he had been traded in 2009, he took the news in very Bruce Bowen fashion, with humility and humor.
I really want to thank the Holtz and Pop and the Spurs organization for allowing me the opportunity to be able to be a Spur and a 3-time champion. That being said, I understand that it is a business, and unfortunately, because of our success, you grow fond of people and places, and this is the reality of the situation. So I've really been received well here in this city, and I appreciate all the love and support that each and every member here in the San Antonio community has shown me.
I know you're sad to go, but do you think this trade makes the Spurs a better team?
No.
Like a number of all-time Spurs greats, Bruce elected to make his post-playing days home, San Antonio. It soon wasn't the only place they shared.
I was so excited and happy for him when he got his number retired, just because guys like that usually don't. And that showed a lot about the organization recognizing him for, you know, what he did with the organization by retiring his number.
To have somebody on your team through 3 championships that you depend on to be a stopper is huge. And all good basketball teams don't even have that. They have guys that try. But Bruce could get it done. On top of that, his 3-point shot won many a game for us in important situations. And he did it over the long run. He didn't do it for 1 or 2 years. He did it for a very long time. So his value to our team was huge, and the championships wouldn't be there without him.
Yes, David Robinson, you know that he has to. That has to happen for him. That has to happen for Ice. That has to happen for Tim, Manu, Tony, but it doesn't have to happen for me. You know, obviously there's an end to the game. Can't play forever. And the recognition of the number being retired was something that was totally out of the blue for me. It wasn't something that I set out to do. And in typical fashion, when Pop tells me, he just speeds right off in the tunnel. And so it just goes to show you what a great community this is, that so many individuals choose to stay here, make this home. I'm a California kid. I am now a Texan. So it's because of the support of the community that has allowed me to make a transition that much more easier to be a resident Texan. Yeehaw.